Here's another round of green white tokens. It's pretty solid. It doesn't have a second white source, obviously, but have a few turns. Hanger back into Nissa's pretty good, as is, so. Evolving Wilds. It's probably Bank Company. I'm definitely gonna play Advocate instead. And I should have played Abbey again, because if I draw Fortified Village, I keep forgetting about that. Plains, perfect. So I just want to go Nissa plus. I can attack first. If I have Dromoka's Command, I mean, it's just a free roll attack for me. Like, even if I had Dromoka's Command, I might just not cast it, because I'd rather cast Nissa, but. I mean, the worst he can do is block and nothing happens, and the best he can do is just not block and just take a 2 free damage, so. Not attacking is very dumb there. And he probably blocks like 90% of the time, but. Once in a while, you get a few free damage in. Another matchup where flipping Gideon is very important, so it's nice to have. Flipping Avacyn is very important, so it's nice that I just have Avacyn Hanger back in my hand. I'm just gonna let Nissa take 2. Just gonna play Gideon and then just plus both my or 0 Gideon plus Nissa, I think. It's possible that. Minusing Nissa is right, or what? Yeah, minusing Nissa is right here. Let's make a 3/3. It's pretty bad against. Well, it's bad against Reflector Mage or Krasis, but it might actually be right because if he Reflector Mages it, that means he taps out, and I get to Avacyn Hanger back while he's tapped out. And like, if he has a company, if he has a company and I minus here, it encourages him to main phase his company to be able to hit. A Krasis or a guy to get through. So I think I'm going to go ahead and do that. Because if he has company, he's probably not just going to pass. He wants to pressure my Gideon if he can. A Tyler's Tracker, geez, that's even better for me. I guess he can save his Tyler's Tracker on his upkeep. I'm gonna emblem my Gideon after I cast Hanger back for 0, so this will survive. Yeah, so I'm just gonna go Avacyn. I guess I should have attacked first. Yeah, that was bad. I want to attack with my knight here. I guess both, since it's just gonna die anyways. Or no, my knight actually. Hold on, I actually want my knight untapped because I want to be able to block this. Because this will be 4. Yeah, okay. Well, my Avacyn will be a 6/5, so a 7/6. So I guess if he has Reflector Mage or something, I want to be able to trade with his Tireless Tracker. Okay. So just that. Actually, that was bad. I should have left this back too. There's no reason. Like, he's just gonna block every single time there, and it might actually not die if he goes. If on his upkeep, it's pretty risky for him to company on his upkeep because if he misses Reflector Mage, everything dies, including his Tyler's Tracker. But if that happens and he hits Reflector Mage, I wish I would have had a 1/2 untapped. Especially with the secure, I'm even more comfortable minusing Gideon there. Yeah, he's just sacking cards for his tracker. So it puts me pretty far ahead. So next turn I get to attack him for 11, and then end of turn secure. Can also play my Sylvan Advocate. It'd be a 5-6 right now. So he's trading. Okay. I'm just gonna end a turn secure for 5. He has a waste in his deck. He must have a Eldrazi Displacer. So he's a Displacer version. I haven't actually seen any of. I've never played against that version yet. I've seen it though. Like I've seen deck lists, but. Jace, yes, he's just dead. Alright. So against Bant, I like Winvala. I like the Stasis Snares. I think Evolutionary Leap is okay. And then I sometimes bring in one Tragic Arrogance, sometimes I don't. Let's see, Felidar Cub I don't think is good. I just added it, so I gotta think about it a little bit, but now they don't have anything for that, so okay. So I gotta cut 6 cards here, if I want all that stuff. I usually cut Secures. I usually take out 2. At the PT, all my teammates were taking out 3. Or they only had 2 main deck, but they were going down to 0 post-board. But I don't know if I like that. I like having one Secure, because it's just a spell that if you're flooded, it's just great. I think I probably have too much stuff, though. I'll just take it out. Let's see. I don't like Inspector here. I always board those out in this matchup. It's just the body just doesn't do anything. Same reason why Secure is kind of bad. The 1-1s or even 2-2s just aren't that great. I gotta cut one more card. Let's see. I think maybe I just won't bring in Tragic Arrogance. Especially if they have Negates, it's even worse. Okay, this hand's pretty good. Especially I can go Pacifist on 2, Pacifist on 3, then pass, flip him, and then on his turn, Stasis Snare. If I want to. It's not a great draw. I do like this card a lot in the matchup, though. It just blocks all of their spells. Pretty annoying. I hope I draw something I can cast. That's not just Evolutionary Leap. Okay, sweet. Likely just is going to company a man step, but that's fine. If I have 2 pacifists in play, it's not like he can really attack me for much. I don't want to get this Evolutionary Leap into play next turn, so I can start digging for Avacyn. So there's Displacer. So you can start displacing his Reflector Mage. I think I might just Stasis Snare that now. Although if he has Dromoka's Command, that's pretty bad for me. So I could just pass. I do want to flip my guys. If I just pass, he can blink one of them. That's not too terrible. I think it's better to just have 3/3s and not let him do that, though. Just hope he doesn't have Dromoka's Command. Well, I could have played my Evolutionary Leap first. Okay, that was bad. Yeah, because if I play that first, then I'm... Dromoka's Command's still very good against me. But at least it hits my leap instead of my Stasis Snare. Because I definitely can't beat Displacer Reflector Mage. Yeah, that was really stupid. I needed to just play my Evolutionary Leap first. I still think, like I said, I would still be in really bad shape and pretty far behind, but I would have a a small chance to win rather than almost no chance to win. Yeah, that was not good. I mean, if I just draw Abyssin here, I can still, if he like, if he taps out to Reflector Mage, because he only gets one blink a turn. No, I guess that's not even good because he can just on my upkeep in response to Abyssin's trigger, blink Reflector Mage. I need to draw Dromoka's Command and have him tap out so I can kill Displacer. Okay. Step one. I mean, again, if he has another Dromoka's Command, I basically can't win, but so he just looks like his company instead. Okay. Crisis Advocate. Just tapping that. Okay. This and this fight this. Okay. I might just be dead. 4, 8, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. I'm going to 1. Yeah, I'm just dead though. I can't. There's nothing I can draw at this point. I guess if I draw Abyssin, I should have sacked that because I need to hit Abyssin. So if I hit, no, even if I hit, I would have to hit like Abyssin and Hangerback. So he's still, and the problem is Abyssin doesn't kill these 4/5s and presumably 4/4. So actually, even if I did and hit Abyssin and Hangerback, I was still dead. I forgot he's going to have another 4/4. I guess he plus, I thought he would minus. I don't think I think I played that game very badly, actually, but we'll board in a Tragic Arrogance. I guess especially if he's the Displacer version, there's even more of a chance that I'd have to kill something. So maybe even Declaration is good? I don't think so. I don't think I'm going to bring in Linvala. It's pretty expensive. Don't want to just die with cards in hand, so I guess I want to go first. Okay, this hand's solid. I need to draw a land, but Canopy Vista would be perfect. It's pretty aggressive. I can start with, you know, Pacifist, and then if I want to, I can Dromoka's Command. You know, if he plays, like, if I play turn to Pacifist and he plays Jace and I don't draw another land, I'll probably just Dromoka's Command, plus and plus one kind of there, fight Jace. It's not good against Reflector Mage, but if I'm missing land drops, so I just have to take a risk like that. Forest, okay, that's good. I could also just play, if he doesn't play anything on his turn, I might just go Nissa minus attack. That doesn't sound great, but it's an option. Okay. See, I could just fight that and attack for 4, but I think I want to use my mana efficiently, and like I said, that's bad against Reflector Mage. Well, this isn't horrible against Reflector Mage, because I can, if I draw a land next turn, I can play Hangerback for 1, minus Nissa, then have Hangerback fight one of his guys. He also just might not have Reflector Mage, which would be great. Okay. That's decent. I think I'm just going to have Nissa take 3. No, I'm going to block. Let's see, so if I have Nissa take 3, goes to 1, like plus a 2, Hangerback. I think it's important to keep it high at this point.
Well, I have this other Nissa in hand, actually. I think it's likely that I plus Nissa the next turn minus it and play another Nissa, so I'm just gonna let it take three. Okay, that was good. Plus Nissa. I think I just want to play. Let's see, I can play Hangar Back for one and then just pass. Or I could just Stasis Snare that. Or I could play Hangar Back for two. I think I like Hangar Back for two the best. Because I don't think I'm going to. I doubt I'm going to be able to use this Dromoka's Command profitably with having a 1-1 and two 0-1s in play. We did have a Reflector Mage, that's annoying. Didn't have another land though, that's good. Now I'm definitely gonna block. Gideon, that was a good draw. So I can make a plant, and then I can Gideon make a 2-2. I could also just ultimate Gideon, but I don't think that's good right now. I want to make a 2-2 right now. This is just forces him to keep committing to attacking my planeswalkers, and if he's not killing them, I can keep getting an advantage out of them, and then next turn I'll be able to untap and have, like, you know, two removal spells or whatever, so I can really get ahead with him. If you ask land company, I'm in kind of bad shape, though. But I think that's kind of true no matter what. So attacking Gideon with both my guys, I think I'm just gonna block with one plant. Then I'll have Gideon take two, then next turn I can make a knight and minus Nissa. Alternatively, I could double chump here, make a plant and emblem Gideon. I think that's actually a little better. Then I'll have a 3-3 here, and then I can even fight his 3-4 I can make this a 4-4 if I want to. I like that. A Gideon emblem's pretty strong, and then, like, just my hangar back is going to be better. When it dies, I'll have actual flyers that can deal damage rather than just 1-1s. Jace, okay. I'm going to want to kill this Jace. Oath. So I could dig for a land. I think I'm going to play Oath. I'd really like to find a land here. Although, actually, I don't know if I really want to find a land with Oath. I might just want to find Gideon or Abyssin, so maybe I'll wait. Because I want to cast Hangerback and Dromoka's Command this turn. I absolutely want to kill his Jace. Actually, I don't even need to kill his Jace that badly. It's not like he can flip. So I'm definitely plussing this. I can play Hangerback for one. And I definitely want to minus this. Give me a 3-3. I might just play Hangerback for one and then kill his Sylvan Advocate. Because then I can Stasis Snare his Jace if I need to. Because Sylvan Advocate's going to get big here soon. I think I like that plan. And I'm pretty sure I want to use Dromoka's Command while he's tapped out. This fights this. This is kind of bad if he has another Reflector Mage, I guess. It's okay against Krasis. I definitely want to get my Oath into play before I cast Stasis Snare. I don't want to make that mistake again. Displacer, okay. He doesn't have any colorless mana, but I think I should probably play it safe and just Just to stasis snare that while I can. So I can also start attacking him if I want to. Let's see, I think I'm going to cast this Oath, see what it finds. I would be okay with Oath just finding a land right now since I have Abyssin in hand. Abby is good. I think I'm going to take Abby here. I can play Abby, so now I can... Let's see, so I stasis snare this, and then plus Nissa, I guess, and I can attack him for 5 if I wanted to. I think I want to attack it, or for 4 rather. If I plus Nissa, I could... Alternatively, I can minus Nissa. That might be better, because if I minus Nissa, then suddenly this can block there. This can block there. Yeah. Although I did just get a Westfell Abbey, so having more creatures is good. I think if I'm not going to minus Nissa, then I don't want to attack with my knight, I think is my plan. And I think that's okay. He only has one card left. And if I kill this, I think I'm pretty far ahead. Like, he's got Duskwatch and Jace, but I'm going to have an Abyssin next turn. And then I'll be able to flip my Abyssin here soon. I guess I don't actually have a way to have one of my creatures die, but it's still just a giant creature that'll be hitting him for, 5 or 6 if I end up minusing this Nissa. I think I'm okay playing a longer game here. And, I have this other Nissa in hand, so, I kind of want to have this one start getting lower, but it's not like I have, it's not like I can cast it next turn, I'm going to be casting Abyssin next turn, so I can minus it next turn and then minus it the following turn. I'll be on 1 when I play my second Nissa if that's what I decide to do. So I think I'm okay with that. Oh shoot, I forgot to charge my hangar back end of turn. That was a mistake. Oops. Okay, so that was good. So now I can flip Abyssin next turn if I want to. And I think I want to flip this. I'd rather... He doesn't have many cards in hand, so it's not like he can really make use of the mana discount. I'm going to minus this and pass. Navika's pretty good right now. It's something that lives through Jace, or through Abyssin. He actually has a lot that lives through Abyssin flip. Between a flip Jace, a flip Nissa, and his advocates, but... a few attacks from Abyssin and he's gonna die. Especially if I minus Nissa next turn. These are gonna be 3 power, so I can start attacking with the... I guess he still is gonna have 2 4/5, so I can't quite attack with these yet, but... These will start being able to attack. And I can also just make a Westfell Abbey here soon, so... He has a colorless source, so if he draws a Displacer, that might be pretty hard for me to beat. So he basically just gets to Reflector Mage at instant speed once a turn. So he's flashing back Dromoka's Command. He might have another Dromoka's Command in his hand. That would be pretty good. There, I guess I'll just flash this in now. So what are his 2 modes? So yeah, he's making me sacrifice an enchantment. He must have another one in his hand. But, he will be able to activate Displacer this turn too. forest. It's another colorless source. Looks like he didn't have another one. Maybe he forgot I could sacrifice my oath. Well, if I untap, I can put Evolutionary Leap into play, and then I have a little more protection from that, so... Assume this is going to be his advocate, maybe? Or maybe he does have another command. Oh, he's had a displacer in hand. Okay. Ugh. Yeah, it's going to be real hard for me to win. I mean, if I could just draw... If I just draw a removal spell for displacer, it's okay. Gideon. I could also just try to brute force him and just start anthemming. I could anthem Nissa, anthem Gideon. Attack for a million. But he can... He can blink my Avacyn, but that's not that bad. He can blink my hanger back, which is pretty bad for me. He can blink any of my tokens, which is pretty bad for me. He's blink his reflector mage, bounce my Avacyn, that's pretty bad for me. Displacer is very good. I'm gonna play Evolutionary Leap. I really wish this hanger back had an extra counter on it, because that is definitely a way I could win. Anthem Nissa, and I should attack him with everything. Three, four. So he has two block, four or five blockers, so he can just block my two of my. He can block two of these guys there. Ugh. So this even this play, he can just bounce my knight and then reflector mage my Avacyn. He can block my knight with reflector mage and then blink reflector mage bouncing my Avacyn. I guess I could draw Tragic Arrogance, that would be very good. That die. I'll do this now. So I'm just gonna make four tokens. They're gonna be two twos, and I can just like Nissa make them three threes, or Gideon emblem them to three threes. He can blink two of them. The problem is he can just blink two of them on one turn, then blink two of them on the next turn. I might have been okay if he didn't have a second colorless source. I can't really double block. I guess I could just keep charging my hanger back. And go for a bigger turn. So how many flyers do I need to hit him with? So if I make five flyers, if he can blink, assuming he can blink two of them. So this turn I can like play and, if I draw a land, I can like play an Anthem Gideon. Then he can just end of turn, you know, blink my hanger back and then force me just to pop it. So I think I just have to pop it now. Another hanger back, that's decent.
Another Gideon's not great. So I get Gideon, Anthem, or Emblem, attack with my guys. I'm sure he would just blink two of them, and then that would put him to. He would take. So my guys would be three threes. So he'd take six, he'd get a 14. That's not very good. I'm just going to attack with my Thopters and see what he does. So I have to attack him. So he's gonna take three of them. I'm just gonna play hanger back for two and just kind of do the same thing. Displaced my 6/6, that makes sense. 3, 4, 5, 6. We actually can displace three things now. I basically have to just draw. If I just draw a removal spell for Eldrazi Displacer, I think I'm in very good shape. I guess he does have a lot of damage he's attacking me with. I think at this point I basically just have to draw Tragic Arrogance. At least I have one in my deck. Ravison's not doing much. Tragic Arrogance, Oath of Nyssa. Okay, so what can I do here? He can blink three of my guys, so that leaves me with two flyers, and I can hit him for 3/4 damage, so that's not quite enough. 4, 8, 12, 16, 17, 18. So I'm super, super dead next turn. I don't think I have any outs here. If I just pass, he can just displace all, like, he can just displace three guys, untap, displace three guys. Then I have two blockers, like, assuming I just hold a Babison. So I can only make one more blocker no matter what play I make. That displacer is disgustingly good in this matchup. Yeah, I'm just dead. There's just absolutely nothing I can do here. No creatures do anything. I needed to draw a removal spell that turn. Alright, well, there was a game against Bant Company. I think the normal Bant Company matchup's pretty good, but I don't know, with Displacer, it might actually be pretty bad for you. I mean, they only have, you know, assuming they just have four Displacers, they only have four Displacers, and you do have a decent amount of removal spells, so it probably doesn't change that much, but I'd definitely, from their side, rather have Displacer than not. It makes the matchup, if you draw and can activate Displacer, I think the matchup becomes pretty good for you. So, anyways, I'll be back in a bit with another round of green-white tokens.